Hello and welcome to Cook UK. Today we're going to show you how to make the perfect short crust pastry. What we have in this bowl here is we've got 55 grams of refined vegetable fat, 55 grams of cooking margarine. That's 110 grams of fat in total. And onto that we poured 220 grams of plain flour. All we're going to do is simply rub in the fat into the flour until it becomes a crumbly mixture. Now that should take about 3 minutes normally. It does depend on what temperature the fat is. It's slightly quicker if the fat has not been taken directly from the fridge as we've done, but it doesn't affect the overall quality of the pastry. It just takes a little bit longer to get really cold fat to form a crumbly mixture. Now if you see what we're doing, rather than mix the whole thing in with our hands, we're actually using the fingertips and raising it up, and all we're trying to do is break up that fat and mix it in with the plain flour. Now as I say, this should take about 3 or 4 minutes, so we'll come back to you in a few minutes when we've completed this. Okay, so the pastry mix is now reasonably crumbly. As we said, much more than about 3 minutes and you really ought to stop, because it becomes a law of diminishing returns. This is reasonably crumbly. That's good enough. If you overdo it, it'll start forming into solid mass. So don't be too worried if there are slightly bigger crumbles in the mix. 2 to 3 minutes, something like that. And then what we're going to do is we're going to add 3 tablespoonfuls of water. 1, 2, 3. And we're just going to cut that into the mixture with a knife until it's relatively easily spread around. Now that initial mixture of 55 grams of cooking margarine and 55 grams of refined fat like Cookeen, you can actually replace that and use all cooking margarine if you want. It's just that we found that you get a better, a lighter pastry mix if you mix the two. Every chef or cook will have their own recipe for short crust pastry. But if it's done correct, one thing that does remain constant is you've got twice the weight of flour to the weight of fat. Now all we're going to do is start gathering this pastry together, and what we want to do is form it into a ball that basically leaves us with a reasonably clear edge to our mixing bowl, because if it does that, you know you've got the mixture about right. It won't form into a ball, you may need to add just a little bit more, but it really is only a little bit more water. You have to be very careful because you can overdo it. And this is short crust pastry. So, that's forming okay there. And as you can see, it's wiped, almost wiped the sides of the bowl. So that pastry mixture is ready. And all we're going to do is take some cling film, put it over it like that, and we're going to place it in the fridge for at least 30 minutes. You can stay in the fridge for a lot longer. You can even freeze this, and it freezes very well, and just take it out and let it defrost and use it direct from the freezer. So That's the pastry, shortcrust pastry mix. Now we'll come back to you. That's how to make shortcrust pastry. All you've got to do is roll it out now and cook it. So once it's been in the fridge, we'll come back to you and we'll roll it out and we'll cook it. So our shortcrust pastry mix has been in the fridge for about half an hour, just over half an hour. We've lightly dusted our flat rolling surface. And now we're going to just with our hands make the shortcrust pastry form into a basic circle there. Now, this is the pie dish that we're going to use for the to be covered by the shortcrust pastry. We're going to fill it with a mixture of gooseberries and other summer fruits. And we're going to use that dish as the template for the size of the pastry topping. So what you do is you just roll it out like this, keep on turning it, and make sure the roller is well floured. Now this is going to take, I don't know, about 3 minutes to actually get it out to the right size. So we'll cut the camera and we'll get back to you when I've rolled it out. But as you can see, it's started to look good already. You should always make a little bit more shortcrust pastry than you actually need, because it's not going to roll out into a perfect circle, as you can see. So make a little bit more than you need, and this should make a little bit more than we need for the thickness we want for that pie dish. So we'll cut away now and come back when it's rolled out. Right, we've rolled out our shortcrust pastry now to just a little bit larger than the correct size. So what we're going to do is we're going to take our pie dish and we're going to put it on the pastry and just press down gently like that. That will leave, I can get it up, that will leave a mark on the pastry. Now actually, if you look at this pie dish, we're not actually going to put it around the edge, so we need to assume that it's just slightly less wide than the mark we've made there. So that's our template there. So what we do is take a knife, and remember this, with this pie dish we're going to make it just slightly smaller because of the edging, and just cut out according to the template. Okay, so we've cut right round the pastry and we'll take that away like that, which leaves us with a template that's just right for that pie dish. Now for those of you who are not interested in cooking the gooseberry pie, just fast forward a bit, because I've got to show people how to fill this pie dish with gooseberries now, but it'll only take a minute. So here's our pie dish. We've cooked the gooseberries, red currants, white currants and black currants for 10 minutes. We added 100 grams of sugar to this. Now you should taste it and adjust the sugar. If you think it's too tart, add a little bit more, because different fruits have different levels of acidity and you'll need different amounts of sugar. And also this personal taste comes into it, how tart you like your pies. So simply pour in the cooked gooseberries and red currants. Now here's the, we reserved a third of the amount of the fruit. so that we can add it in at this stage. This just adds a little bit of texture to the fruit when it's cooked, so that not all of it is mushed down. Some of it actually has some texture. And then just even it off. That looks fine. Okay, back to the pastry bit of the pie. Let's just get hold of this. Now, there's different ways to move pastry. This is not too large a bit, actually. We could actually just lift it over there. But we're going to do it the proper way. And this you can do certainly with larger bits. You put your rolling pin like that. Just lift the pastry up like that. And that means you can transfer it with minimum damage, let's say that. We'll just move our pie here. Place the pastry over it. Nothing presto. You just need to move it a little bit one way. Get it exactly even. Hey presto. There's our pie. Now, what we should have done, we'll do it now, is to brush some egg yolk. You can use water if you want, but we're using egg yolk. Just round the edge of the pie dish where the pastry is going to come in contact with it. You can also do it on the pastry as well itself. This will just help hold the layer of shortcrust pastry in position. And we'll do the same on the other side. As I say, it's a lot easier if we'd done it earlier on. But there you go. So there's our pie almost ready. So what we need to do is crimp the edges. Now I'm not the expert at this, but my partner is, but here we go. All you're doing is pressing it in to the edge of the pie dish. Like that. And then make a few dents in it, however you like. Just to give it some texture when it cooks. Okay, so that's sealed the surface of the pie. We want to just make a cut here so that some of the moisture can escape when it starts to boil as steam. So that's fine. So then what we're going to do is brush the top of the shortcrust pastry roughly all over. This is one beaten egg here, which should, one beaten egg yolk, which should be enough to seal off the edges and give a coating to the top. Now the reason we are coating the top like this is because it makes the pastry go a little bit more brown than it would normally, and it gives it that lovely golden colour. So there we are. For those who came here for shortcrust pastry, excuse me, that's going to make shortcrust pastry, put it on top of a pie. And the final thing, because it's a fruit pie, is we're going to add just a little bit of sugar on the top to decorate it.
Oh yes.
Okay. Okay, so our fruit pie is ready to go in the oven. We put the oven on 220 degrees. Gas mark, let me just look. Gas mark 7. So we're putting that in there now. And what we'll do is let that cook for about 10 minutes and then we'll turn it down to 190 degrees and let it cook for a further 30 minutes or so until the short crust pastry has turned a golden brown. So we'll get back to you in a few minutes, well, in about 40 minutes when it's done there, and show you the results. So there you have it, perfect short crust pastry covering a gooseberry, red currant, black currant and white currant filling. It's not as difficult as you think with our step-by-step instructions from www.cookuk.co.uk. Happy eating!